Is this a good idea or bad one?
Hold up, time out. Why are you showing B-roll of a guy playing quarterback that's a tight end? Hmm. Where to play it? No. I need to see some plays of him catching a pass.
I saw him running the ball.
No. You see him taking the direct snap. I want to see. Now, when I watch clips of Kyle Pitts and I watch of all the Travis Kelce and Darren Waller, they're not throwing passes. They're catching passes.
You're missing the point.
No, the point is that you look. Let's not beat around the bush. Everybody knows why he got this opportunity. Mm. Everybody knows that. Mm. He's from Jacksonville. They're trying to sell tickets. Shad Khan is trying to sell tickets. They haven't been an item basically since Brunel has been there with Jimmy Smith and Keenan McCardell, Fred Taylor. That's a very, very long time. His ex-college coach is now the head coach of the Jacksonville Jaguars. So we know what this is, Skip. Let's not make this more like here's a guy that was very deserving of an opportunity. Do you know if I could just like open my inbox and show people how many guys that have played college ball that asked me, Shannon, do you know how can I get a trial? How can I get a walk-on? I was a this. I was a that. Do you know anybody? Mm. I got nothing. Mm. I got nothing. Harris, a guy that has not played in 6 years, has not played in the regular season game in 9 years, and going to switch positions at the highest level and gets an opportunity. Mm. Really? So once I heard this, I was like, he's getting signed. This is not no, he worked out and we'll see. He was going to get signed all along. You know that. I know that, Skip. And so I'm just trying to figure out how many guys you think have caught. I want to know Urban. Urban has been a head coach probably, 25 years, Skip? Mm-hmm. 25 years at the college level. I want to know how many guys at Bowling Green, Utah, Florida, and Ohio State had not played football in 6 years. And Urban Meyer gave them an opportunity to play football. Mm. But that's what he did for Tim Tebow. Tim Tebow hadn't played in 6 years. And he's going to switch position, a position he's never played. And he gets an opportunity. We know what this is. Not that he can play. He thought he was a great athlete. Oh, Tim Tebow's a great athlete. Try baseball, what happened? Mm. Now, Tim Tebow is addicted to fame. Tim Tebow cannot let it go. That's what this is. He's the same guy that was in Denver. Mm. He loves the attention. He craves the fame. He craves the limelight. And here we are again. Mm. But guess what? I believe there's a better than 60% chance that he makes the team. Why? Because Urban is guy. What is he? Oh, he's great for the locker room. What? Ain't nobody. I was in a locker room for 14 years. I was one of the dominating boys. Ain't nobody listening to a third string, a backup tight end to get motivated. Mm. And, oh, he going to help Trevor Lawrence. Help Trevor Lawrence do what? Mm. Really? Man, they make all the excuses. He going to do this, this, and this. If he could do all of that, he'd still be in the league. If he could play, he can't. He couldn't. And you need to face the fact. He needs to face the fact. At some point in time, he's going to run out of coaches that get an opportunity to be a head coach and can give him an opportunity. Mm. You okay? You lived out your dream. You played quarterback because they asked him. Mm-hmm. You remember when they was going to trade him, John Elway was going to trade him. See, this is a very little known fact. They asked him, Tim, where do you want to go?
It's not a little known fact. Everybody knew that.
What did they know?
About Jacksonville or the Jets.
Oh, and he wanted to go
it
where?
It was widely reported.
And he wanted to go where? New York, because it was a bigger market. Mm. Because he, not that they got a chance to play.
Better team.
Skip, better team or a chance to play? Mm. I thought he wanted to play. I thought Tim Tebow was going to change the fortune.
A little known fact that I reported on ESPN was that Rex Ryan called Tim Tebow and said, I will give you a chance to win the starting job. And he got no chance to win the starting job from Mark Sanchez.
Another little known fact. If you don't mind me asking, can you tell me the agent? Who's Rex Ryan's agent? Who's Tim Tebow's agent?
What does that matter?
Oh, okay. What does that mean?
Well, apply it to what we're talking
about. You know
it. It means what?
Jimmy Sexton represents Rex Ryan.
Yep.
He represents Tim Tebow. Boy, that's how it works.
Then how did Rex Ryan, a Jimmy Sexton client, screw Tim Tebow?
Ain't nobody screwed him because Skippy couldn't play.
Oh. Wait, are we talking about the same Tim Tebow who took your Denver Broncos at 1-4 to a division championship and beat Ben Roethlisberger by throwing for 316 yards in a playoff game? Are we talking about that guy can't play?
Skip.
Are you kidding me?
So why
did you put on blinders? So what did you see?
If he was so good, why wouldn't anyone else give him a chance?
Are you finished yet?
I'm finished.
Oh, good. It's my turn. So the question is, is this a good idea or a bad idea? And the answer is, this is a great idea for Urban Meyer and Jacksonville right here, right now, and it has exactly zero to do with selling tickets. They have the first pick in the draft. They have a generational quarterback in Trevor Lawrence. They have Urban Meyer making his first big splash in pro football. They don't need to sell any more tickets in Jacksonville. They need to win football games, and Tim Tebow will, number one, make the team, even though our Fox bet says the odds are against him making the team. He will make the team because there is no way Urban Meyer signed him to cut him in training camp. He's not going to put him through that. So it's a done deal that he will be signed and he will play next year. And you are completely missing the boat on how he will be used, because nobody understands how to use Tim Tebow any better than Urban Meyer. Urban Meyer coached Tim Tebow at Florida, as we all know, and in their time together, they went 48-7. And Tim Tebow helped him win two national championships, the first one not as the starting quarterback, and Tim Tebow did win a Heisman, and Tim Tebow left Florida as the all-time SEC leader in passing efficiency, which is like quarterback rating, as the all-time SEC leader in completion percentage. Who knew at 67%? All-time leader in the history of that conference. This is a great conference. Tim Tebow left Florida as the all-time leader in touchdown to interception ratio. 88 touchdown passes to only 15 interceptions. All-time leader in the history of the Southeastern Conference. And he left as the all-time leading rusher as a quarterback, yards gained as a quarterback, and the all-time SEC career leader in touchdowns scored at any position with 57 touchdowns scored, because this man has a nose for the goal line. Mm-hmm. This man can run the football. This man is about 6'2", probably now 250 pounds. I saw with my own eyes out here at his baseball showcase about four, it was back in August of 2016. I witnessed in the outfield at USC, he timed a 40-yard dash at 4.6 seconds, which is, it's not great, but it's pretty good at 250 pounds. Mm-hmm. He is a nifty runner of the football. He can make you miss here and there, and he can run through you and over you, and he is a nifty handler of the football. This has gadget guy written all over him, and nobody understands how to use Tim Tebow better in packages, to maximize those packages in small but dynamic doses, than Urban Meyer. Just see what happened as a freshman at Florida with Tim Tebow. Again, Chris Leak was the starting quarterback. We all remember that.
Yeah.
How great was Chris Leak? Not that great, because he went undrafted. He got to play one preseason game with the Bears and just didn't make it. He went to Kansas City and didn't make it. He bounced around other leagues, but he did not make it in the National Football League. Mm-hmm. So he wasn't a great player, but he was a very good college player.
Correct.
And they were able to beat Ohio State in the championship game, just wiped them out 41-14. And they got there because of small doses of Tim Tebow, because he threw only 33 passes that year, but completed 22 of them. Most of them were red zone packages, goal line packages.
Jump passes.
A lot of jump passes and a lot of run pass option, because he's a big, strong kid who has a nice handle on the football, and he can make good, quick choices of, do I run it, keep it, jump and throw it? What do I do with it? And because of that, he also ran it 89 times for 469 yards as a freshman at Florida, and it contributed to a dynamic package that helped them go win the national championship. So to me, you're missing the boat. He will not line up as a true tight end. He won't be split out. He maybe occasionally he'll be in the slot, but he's going to be an H-back, mostly lining up in the backfield in very small doses. I'm going to say he might throw it a couple of times a game on run pass options.
So he's going to be Taysom Hill.
What's that?
He's going to be Taysom Hill?
I'm not even sure he'll get as many opportunities as Taysom Hill gets. But I'm going to say he throws it a couple times a game. I'm going to say he runs it, I don't know, 3-4 times maybe a game. It all depends on goal line situations, nose for the goal line. And just the rub-off effect. Nobody understands the contagious football charisma of Tim Tebow. The force of competitive nature that he is better than Urban Meyer understands it. And he knows that just having him on the field, having him in the locker room, having the presence of Tim Tebow will ignite and inspire younger players. Skip. They know about his mystique. Skip. They know what happened. Skip. They're not too young to understand.
The 50th guy on the roster ain't rubbing off on anybody. Hey, it's not happening.
He will make plays for this team. Just plays here and there. Just watch. He may line up occasionally in the Wildcat. They may snap it directly to him every once in a while. And you cannot tell me he won't help Trevor Lawrence know the ropes, learn the ropes.
He didn't know him.
What are you talking about?
Know what ropes? He couldn't read defenses.
I'm talking about how to handle the brightest spotlight in NFL history. Was there any more focus on any one player than on Tim Tebow in 2011 in Denver? He was it. He was the story of the whole year as the starting quarterback for the Denver Broncos. Yeah. Nobody knows just the gravity, the magnitude of spotlight better than Tim Tebow. He can help. And furthermore, he can take a little pressure, a little bit of the attention off Trevor Lawrence in a good way early on to let him ease into the job.
Think about this, Skip. Urban Meyer gets the job, his first job as an NFL head coach. Mm-hmm. He gets arguably one of the Mel Kiper says he's the fourth-rated quarterback that has ever graded in 43 years of doing it. And one of your big acquisitions, you signed Tim Tebow. Really?
Yeah, really. Mm-hmm.
After 6 years of being away from the game, after 9 years of not playing in a regular season game,
okay,
this is what
I want to make a quick point here that's very important. It's not like Tim Tebow went away from competitive sports because he has been fighting his butt off for the last 5 years to play the sport of baseball, where he had been out for 11 years, started completely over, and amazingly made the all-star team at AA. Amazingly made it all the way last year to AAA. Amazingly was on course to be with the Mets this year in spring training.
And then what happened?
He knew what happened. His head coach from Florida got the job at Jacksonville. That's what happened.
Hello, you mean to tell me you're that close? You scratched and clawed. You've been at this.
His first love was always football. He said it from the start.
I get all that.
He was forced to play baseball.
No, he wasn't forced. No, yeah, his inability to play the quarterback position forced him to go to another trade. Exactly. Huh. And he thought he was that good of an athlete that he could switch sports after not playing a sport for over a decade. And now he comes back. Skip, you told me, you said the NFL turned its back on him. So they still did. So why is he back?
Because his college coach understands Tebow magic.
There you go.
Well,
there
he had huge success with him. And he said, I could have Tim Tebow. I could have him for a few big plays a game. I'll take him.
I love how you read off all those stats. But has there ever been any other Heisman Trophy winning quarterback that didn't make it in the NFL? What about running back? What about Biletnikoff Award winning wide receivers? Has there anybody that's had college credentials like Tim Tebow not been able to make it in the NFL?
There is only one Tim Tebow that I've ever seen. I've never seen anything like did for your Denver Broncos in 2011. Never seen anything like it. Have you? You ever seen anything like it?
I've seen a lot of guys that have college acclaim and cannot make it in the NFL.
Oh, I do too. A whole lot.
Yes. He's one of them.
Yep.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.